Hello everybody, it's me, Cozy Sims, and I am back with another speed build in The Sims 3. I really love how this turned out. It is a L-shaped home, and I've made L-shaped homes before, but they didn't really turn out as well as I hoped that they would. And so I'm really excited about how this one turned out. I had somewhat of a floor plan. I knew what the front of the house looked like, but I didn't really know what the back of it looked like. Like, I knew what the side, like that, like the right side, and I knew what the front of it looked like and everything, but I had no idea about the back. So I think I just pop out like the back a little bit. Here you see I'm struggling a little bit. But yeah, this house is like, it's super big. Like, there's been a few people commenting asking about if I could make like a big home, and I think I delivered. This house is huge. So there is a master bedroom and a master bathroom on the first, on the bottom floor, which, hello, it's so nice. Sorry, I was trying to adjust my mic a little bit. But yeah, master bedroom, master bathroom on the first floor, and then there is three bedrooms on the second floor, and there's two bathrooms on the second floor, and there's also like a little area for like a washer and a dryer. But yeah, and I completely furnished the downstairs, but I did nothing with the upstairs. Like, I popped the flooring and the wall in there, and I called it a day. I also made a really pretty, like, chandelier type thing where it's open to, like, down below. And I thought that looked really pretty. Also, so do you see the corner where the roof, like, facing, like, where the front-facing part of the house and the side part of the house meet, like that little corner, like where the you know what I mean, like the roofing where it connects. So after all was all done, I noticed that like a little part of the roof was missing there. So if that happens, like, to you, like if it comes like that, because, you know, this house will be available to download like all my houses, you can just like delete it and add your own roof if you want. I was just over it. I actually built the shell of this house like a week or so ago, and it's just been sitting in my videos, like not doing anything. And so I figured I'd you know decorate it and do the voiceover and upload it and stuff, so you guys can have access to this gorgeous house. Like, it's one of my favorites that I've built. I think it's because, like, it looks so different than what I've, like, built before, if that makes any sense. I'm also in the process of getting a new microphone, so for a little bit of background, my boyfriend is a musician, like he's in a band and everything, and they have some like high quality microphones that they're not using at the moment, and so they're letting me use one. And I'm really excited. I'm not really sure what like the brand is. I'm pretty sure it's supposed to record like instruments, but they said that it'll work fine for just voiceovers and stuff too. So yeah, He also gave me a mic stand and a pop filter. I think it's what that thing is called. The big circular thing that usually sits in front of your mic. But yeah. And it's not like one of those mic stands that like attaches to your desk. It's like a musician mic stand. But it's adjustable, and it was free. Like, I thought I was gonna have to go online and like buy all these like things for myself and spend like hundreds of dollars. But I literally only need, so since it's a musician microphone, I need a preamp, which like allows me to plug it into my computer, I think is what preamps are for. But yeah, so I'm still using my like cheap $20 microphone that I got on Amazon like 3 years ago. But honestly, that's better than like my crappy headset mic that I was using that picked up like a bunch of humming in the background. But yeah, that's pretty much the only exciting thing that's happened in my life, which is kind of sad. It's actually been super duper cold here. I think my weather app on my phone said it was 0 degrees outside. I'm like, what? And then I think it said it feels like negative 20 or something like that, which is insane. Because like, as a delivery driver, like I deliver for Pizza Hut, like for a living, I have to like drive in it, and my poor little car. We call her Ruby because she's a little red mirage, and she was struggling yesterday because it was even colder. It was like in the negatives all day yesterday, and so I have a little heating pad in my lap where my chair is, and I got my blankets, and my boyfriend's mom actually gave us a few heated blankets that like plugs in and whatnot, and I'm really excited about those. Like, I'm really excited to use those. Cause our furnace on our furnace that only goes up to like 71. We can't get it to go any higher. But yeah. That's pretty much everything that's been going on. I bought a bunch of new books last Tuesday, which I think I already went over in my last video. I got about 10 of the series of Unfortunate Event books, and I read the first one within like an hour of being home, because those books aren't very like big, if you know what I mean. If you've ever seen these books, they were in the teenager section, like the teenage novel section of Goodwill. But I bought like 15, 16 books, and I only paid like $30 for them, so I thought that was a steal, to be honest. But yeah, this house. The roofing gave me a little bit of issues, but as you can see, we're past that already. I've been trying to watch video. I've been watching videos on like how to make video, like my videos and my my voiceovers more interesting, and somebody suggested to that I script it out, like make a script for it. I don't like the idea of just like reading from a script, and like I just feel like that's kind of fake. Like, when I'm talking to you guys, I want to feel like I'm actually talking to you guys, if that makes any sense. But yeah, I just want to make it seem like we're actually, like, talking about this stuff, you know? Instead of like, oh, I mean, this is blah blah blah, this is this, and this is this, and have a good day. Like, you know what I mean? I guess don't like the idea of scripted. Because it doesn't seem genuine. I want to seem genuine when I make these videos. And that might mean that I say the word a million times. And for that, I'm sorry. but that's the only way that I can think to transition from one topic to the other. So if you guys notice that whenever I'm transitioning from, like, between topics, I go, a lot of ums. And if that bothers anybody, I'm sorry. Also, something exciting. I made a Discord server for my followers and me to communicate. And there's, like, a bunch of fun channels in there. It's not too fancy. There's literally only me and one other person in there, and he's a friend that I invited, because I think he also plays The Sims, if I'm not wrong. I hope so. But I would really appreciate if you guys joined it, and you know, there's a section in there where you guys can share builds that you're working on. There's a book section where you guys can talk about, like, books that you're reading if you're into reading books. And I'm just really excited for people to join, if people join anyway. I really hope that people do join, because I would love to, like, I guess feel like it's a good way to, like, connect with you guys more. Like, I would love to be able to, you know, do that. But yeah, the link, like, I'll put an invite link in the description below. And all that fun jazz. But yeah. That's pretty much the only, like, new things that I have been going on. Or I've had going on? Is that the word? Oh my gosh, I am all over the place, and we still have, like, 7 minutes left of this voiceover. Oh boy. What's everybody else up to? I recently changed my name. I'm still getting used to it. I changed my name from Little Simmer was my name before. And I am now Cozy Sims, and I was really excited because I looked up, before, like, I make a name, like, before I, like, chose my name on YouTube in the beginning, I looked up if anybody else had my name, like, the Little Simmer name, and there was a lot of people that had the name, but I think they were just, like, user, like, you know, they didn't upload stuff, they just had an account with the name, and so I felt okay about having it. But I looked up Cozy Sims when I knew I wanted to change it, and I didn't see anybody with that name. So, you know, because I like cozy styled games like Stardew Valley and The Sims and, you know, stuff like that, and so I thought Cozy Sims was very catchy. And I remade my banner on YouTube and my intro and my ending card, which is, I love it. I love it so much. I also want to get back into my Let's Play that I started, because I started a Legacy Challenge and I haven't uploaded a video for that in, like, a week or so. So I want to get, you know, pop some more, you know, videos. I want to, like, get some more videos of that out. But yeah, I've managed to talk my way all the way through the, like, to the inside. And it's pretty much all open concept, which I like. The only rooms that are, like, closed off downstairs is the master bedroom and the master bathroom. Everything else is open. Like, even, like, I made a little study area. Like, that doesn't have a door. That just has an archway in it. And I just thought it was really pretty. And I guess I love open concept houses. Like, yeah, you can, you know, close everything off. But that, you know, it doesn't let natural lighting in. If that makes any sense. Also, I started putting a fireplace right there. And I started putting, yeah, we're working on the kitchen right now. Looking back, I definitely could have made that kitchen work on the right side. But I was having issues with the cabinets and, you know, all that stuff. And so I decided to move it. But, like, I really liked the fridge and the stove and that little corner thing. But, you know, this kitchen, like, the kitchen on the left side looks good, too. I put the dining room on the other side where I originally wanted the kitchen. And then there's a little diagonal pop-out on the right side of the house as well that I didn't do anything with. I started putting like a little custom content bench and stuff, but it, you know, it just didn't look good. So I didn't clutter up the kitchen too much because I wanted it to be functional. So I just put a few like knickknacks and stuff around. Because, you know, a kitchen shouldn't, you know, I like, you know, cluttered kitchens a little bit, like kitchens that look lived in, but I want to be able to use my kitchen, you know, I want to be able to use it, like, and not have to step around a bunch of crap, if that makes any sense. But I really like how this kitchen turned out. I used the stuff from Late Night, I think is what this expansion is. It's very modern, and this house just looks like a modern home. Like, even just the, like, I didn't bother to change the color of the walls. I guess, you know, I made it dark, and I thought that looked pretty. Usually I try to, like, make different, like, backsplashes and stuff, but I just thought the dark walls looked beautiful with the flooring that I chose. And if you download this house, you should get all the custom content that I use. And, you know, if you don't know how to install custom content, or if you don't know how to install houses, I'll try to remember to link the video that I made explaining how to do it. Because I did make a video explaining how to install custom content. Actually, if you click on my name, it'll bring up my channel, and it'll be like the very first video you see. It's the video that autoplays, pretty much. But yeah, if you, like I said, if you download this house, you'll get all the custom content. Easy as that. But yeah, we're working on the little... Oh, we're done already. Oh, and there's me saving my game, because I was afraid that my game was going to crash. Which, I don't know why I was afraid that it was going to crash. Ever since I installed the smoothness patch, it hasn't crashed. Which is really surprising. I'm really enjoying the smoothness patch, by the way. If you guys have any lag in your game at all, I highly... please, for the love of goodness, go download the smoothness patch. It'll change your life. It literally changed mine. But yeah, I think we're working on the master bathroom now, and we were done just like that. I am popping these rooms out like crazy. But I think we only have like not even a minute left of this video. So I'm going to leave you guys here. And if you like this video, and if you like this house, you know, give this video a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe if you're new. Because I love getting, you know, new faces around here. I like sharing my stuff with you guys. And, you know, the link to my Discord server will be in the description below as well. And I will see you all in the next video. Bye, guys.